Hello everyone, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you how to make this scene that you see on the screen right now, 3D text with a shadow, the camera rolling over it, using a 3D camera tracker. I've done that a few times already, but this is a little different with the shadow and more of a moving scene instead of a still. Start out in Fusion, then go to One Viewer. This is a 14-second clip. I got this from Pixabay, so you can get it there. Put the playhead at frame 0 with the media in selected. Shift space and camera tracker. I have to use this on-screen keyboard because I'm paralyzed. I can't use my hands and arms. And the camera tracker tab should be selected automatically. Just hit auto track. And it'll track the whole scene. After it's done tracking, if you have your camera's information, you can select this tab and put the information right here. But Resolve is good at figuring it out. So we'll go to the next tab, Solve, and hit Solve. And it's done solving. You want this average solving error to be below 1. And it is. I was hoping it wasn't. I'm going to show you how to delete some of them. I'll do that anyhow. You do that with, I usually use these two top sliders. I'm going to drop that one down. One, we'll take some of these out. Sometimes it can go the other way and you end up with more. We don't want that because we're just under 1 now. Move them just a little bit. Come down here to clear. That deletes them. And then resolve. Every scene is different, so you just have to play with the adjustments and keep reclearing. Try to go a little bit at a time. If you go too much, you won't have enough tracks. And it'll let you know. Okay, I'm not going to play around with it anymore because I'll probably end up without enough tracks. But that's pretty much how you do it. Play with them and you'll figure it out. Then go to Export, 3D Scene Transform. Go to Unalign. Go back to the beginning, frame 0. You don't want to pick too big of an area. You only want to pick a few of the trackers. You make it too big, the text will want to slide along the plane as you get close to it. I select that spot right there. I come over here and set from selection. That's the origin. That is the area that I just selected. Then come down to set from selection again, make sure it's on plain ground. It's working on the ground, not like a wall. Select it. I like to hit aligned afterwards, but you don't have to. And then hit export. And over to the left, you'll see you got a bunch of nodes showed up. We don't need the camera tracker anymore. Sorry about the mess. I should have moved them while they were still highlighted. This first node here, this is camera tracker. This is actually the render node. It's already set the hardware for 3D. We are going to change the lighting and shadows, but I'll wait and show you why we're doing it. Get a 3D text node. Plug it into the ground plane. Put the text you're liking in. Then go to the ground plane. And go to transform. On the X, hit the little dot and reset that to 0. And it should be standing vertical now. Now go back to the text node. Set your tracking and your font, pick that. Your size, do all that now. And then go down to excursion. I'm going to set mine to 0.06. Take the subdivisions all the way up. Smoothing angle all the way up. Then right click on the bevel depth expression. Carry the pick whip over the bevel width and let go. Now they both move at the same time. I like 0.0063, but set yours to your liking. And go to custom. Highlight the bottom corner and then handle straight up. Highlight the top left one. Hit F on the keyboard. And bring the handle straight out all the way to the left. And the top right, this is the back of the text. We don't need no bevel on that. We want it flat. So bring it over something like that. And bring the subdivisions all the way up. Give it a color. Now we'll go ahead and animate this. With the text node selected, go to the transform. I'm going to straighten mine out a little bit with the Y and the rotation. Before we do that, we want to scrub this. Make sure the text stays in one spot when we get close to it. Make sure it doesn't start pushing along with the camera. I'm going to go somewhere right about there. I'm on 30 FPS. Frame rate, you may have to adjust yours accordingly. Set the keyframe on the X. Move the camera close. And then set the X to minus 90. Something like that. Right click on the text. Go to dual viewers. Put the merge viewer one. You'll see a bunch of little purple lines. That's the ground plane. That will show in the video or picture sometimes. Doesn't always. I think I can barely see it in mine right now. But to get rid of it, select the ground plane. Go to controls. Visibility. And deselect visible. All the green are your tracking marks. Let's add light to this. We'll get a spotlight. And you can see it there. Now go ahead and select the what's called camera tracker, which is a render. Enable lighting and shadows. And your text should be black. Go to spotlight. And go to transform. Rotate the Z-axis to the right and you'll start seeing the text. And then I'm going to raise it up. Before we do that, go to controls, open the angle all the way. You may like that look there, but I don't. I'm going to bring the light up so you can see the text when it's flat. Okay, right click on the text node, copy. Click away down here, right click and paste instance. Plug that into the merge. If you don't know what an instance is, it's an exact copy of whatever you've taken it off from. Everything that's highlighted in green, and even if it is not highlighted, it's coupled to the original node. We're going to de-instance some stuff here. start with the excursion depth, right click, and deinstance. Then go to shading. We're going to deinstance all the color. We'll start with the red, right click, and deinstance. And go all the way down. May as well include the alpha too. We don't really have to, but we will. And the opacity, deinstance that as well. Then go to transform. And right click on the X. And deinstance. And then double click on the X to delete the keyframes on it. We carried them over from the original node. Now when you rotate it, you can see the back ones are laying down. Set that to minus 90. Then go back to the text tab. Change the color to black. Sometimes it'll show here, you come through, so you're going to want to lay them, make sure you lay the excursion to nothing. So turn the excursion all the way down. And if you want to set your shadow so it ain't so dark, go to shading and turn the opacity down some. I'm going to move that a little bit closer. I'll delete the keyframe. Move a little closer and redo it. Back to 90. Minus 90. That looks good. I'm going to set my excursion depth a little deeper too. With the text node selected. Back to the text tab. I'm going to go 0.08. Well, there you go. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.